In today's episode, I'll show you how to add an HDRI lighting to your 3D scene inside of After Effects. For this tutorial, I'll be using After Effects 24.6.2. If you're using an older version, you may not have access to these features and might be unable to follow along. Alright, let's begin. I already have my 3D model imported to After Effects, and make sure you are in After Effects Advanced 3D Render Engine. With that out of the way, let's go ahead and add an environment light. Head over to Layer, then New, and select Light. Perfect. Now, for light type, go ahead and select Environment Light. If you don't see it, it's because you are in an older version of After Effects. I am using version 24.6.2. With the environment light selected, you can see Cast Shadows is not grayed out. I'll leave it selected and select OK. We can see our 3D model is now casting shadows. If we look at the light's properties, we can see that the source is from the default HDRI map that After Effects provides. We can also increase the intensity if we liked, and uncheck the cast shadows if we wanted to. I am going to move around the scene using my camera controls. I'm using a MacBook Pro M1 Max, and it's struggling to render the scene. We can also rotate the light by going to its transform properties. We can rotate on its X, and Y properties. Now, how is this different than using the spotlight or any other light? Well, let me show you. I'll go ahead and create a new solid layer. I'll name it Shadow, and I'll leave everything as is, and select OK. I'll make this layer 3D, and when I change its X rotation value to negative 90, we can see that our solid layer is capturing the shadow casted from our 3D model. But what if we want to export this with a transparent background? Well, that won't be a problem. Just head over to the layer's material option settings, and under Accept Shadows, change it to Only. And now we have our 3D model and its shadow ready for export. But what if we want to add our own HDRI map? No problem. Let's head over to the internet to search for an HDRI map. I usually get my HDRI maps from Polyheaven. In Polyheaven, I'll head over to the Assets section and select HDRI. From there, I'll choose the Indoor category and pick an HDRI that best suits my scene. I'll set the resolution to 2K, since I've had After Effects crash when using 8K or 4K files. Though, that may just be my computer. I'll leave the format as EXR and click Download. Perfect. Now that the file is downloaded, I'll go back to After Effects. Back in After Effects, I will import my HDRI file from the Downloads folder, and select Open. Perfect. I'll drag it to the bottom of my timeline. Now, in Environment Light Settings, under Light Options, I'll change the source from default to the new HDRI map I just imported. You'll notice that the HDRI map layer becomes hidden and our scene is now lit by the HDRI map. We can also rotate the light to adjust how it illuminates our scene. But what if we want to remove all the grainy from our scene? For that, we will have to change our render settings. I'll first take a photo of our scene now, and in Advanced 3D, I will select the Render Options button. I'll change the render quality to 10 and the smoothness to 10. I'll leave the resolution as full 60 megabytes, and I'll select OK. I've sped up this section. Originally, it took me 2 minutes to render this frame. Now that it's done, let's compare the two. You can see the graininess has been reduced compared to what we had before. I'll take a new snapshot and increase our render settings to 20 to see how much of a difference that makes. This time, it took 6 minutes to render on my computer, but thanks to the editing magic, it only takes a few seconds here. Wow, almost all of the grain is gone. Well, let's compare the images side by side. You can see that as we increase the settings, we get better quality, though our render time also increases. Okay, you now know how to add your own HDRI lighting to your 3D scene inside of After Effects. I'm excited to see After Effects continue improving its 3D features. I can only imagine how much better these tools will get in the future. If you'd like to download this project file, head over to the tutosdigital.com website, where you can find this and many other tutorials. If you found this video helpful, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching Tutos, your tutorial channel. Till the next one.